terrible day. My legs felt like 4 pounds of cheese in a 2-pound bag. I didn't know what to do. My eyes were bloodshot, and actually my legs were bloodshot as well. It's strange, but I was happy. I got into my car. I decided I was gonna leave the city, gonna go south, gonna have a holiday. So I got in my car and I wondered why I wasn't running, and then I realized I didn't have any keys. So I went in the house, got my keys, came back out, started the car, and drove down the highway. The highway shimmered like black incense on the bald head of a Buddhist monk. I drove down to the highway, and I got to the big city of Miami, the steaming seedy city, the city that's so seedy, they have trees there. Well, I went into the nearest hotel, and I went up to the door, and I said, I'd like a room. And I realized I was outside, I had to go inside. So I went inside, and I walked up to the desk, and I said, I'd like a room, please. And they said, all right, and they gave me a key. And I turned around, and there waiting for me was the concierge.
Concierge!
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 Well, he looked at me, and then I looked at him, and then he looked back at me, and then I took a putty knife and I rubbed it against his cheeks in a very provocative way, and he turned around and said, follow me. I followed him up the stairs. I went to my room. He opened the door for me, and then he hit me in the back of the head with a big silver shovel. I said, what's that about? He said, you get it free with the room. Who was I to argue? I went in. My whole room was covered with soap. Little soaps all over the room, everywhere, in the bed, on the ceiling, everywhere. I said, what's with the soap? And he says, what, you don't like soap? I said, no, I'll take it, thanks. He left the room, but then gave me a stare that almost turned my blood to blood. Anyway, I lay down on the bed, and it was a hot day, so I was tossing and turning and tossing and turning, and then the soap started to lather up and lather up, and I was gonna die, I was gonna suffocate, so I called the front desk, and they sent up the concierge!
Concierge! Concierge! Concierge!
Up and down, and he looked at me like I was 4 pounds of shit in a 2-pound bag, and I looked back at him like he was 4 pounds of shit in a 4-pound bag, and then he looked at me like I was 6 pounds of shit in a pound and a half bag, and I looked at him like he was 18 kilograms of shit in a thimble. And then I stabbed him in the face, and then he bit my head off and put it in a bag, and that's when I fell in love with him, the concierge.
Concierge!
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 Now we live in a small beach house, on a small beach, on Long Island. It's a long, small island, but I love him well, and he loves me well, and sometimes we take a trip down the highway that's glistening like a Buddhist monk with incense ablaze, and we think of the day we first met, me and the concierge.
Concierge.